Imagine a day. You wake up on the sunny morning in California, complete your breakfast, and then attend an important business meeting in London in the afternoon, and came back to California for a dinner. It seems impossible, right? Yeah, it is impossible with current technology. But what if I told you that this imaginary day can become a reality soon? Within the next 2 to 3 years, you may complete a round trip around the Earth within just a day. And it is possible due to SpaceX's ambitious project. Elon Musk, most beloved billionaire and CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, has a visionary plan to make humanity a multi-planetary civilization.
The long-term goal of SpaceX is perhaps not a very commercial sounding goal at all, which is it's to really build the technologies necessary to make life multiplanetary.
And the first step towards that goal is to transport humans and cargo to the Mars and build a sustainable city there. But to get there, we need a gigantic rocket which can take humans and cargo to the Mars through the vast emptiness of space. That's why SpaceX is building a Starship spacecraft, or also previously known as BFR, which is a gigantic, fully reusable two-stage spacecraft. It is 120 meters tall and can deliver almost 100 tons of cargo to the Moon and Mars. You can see my dedicated video on a Starship by clicking on the I button, and also I will add a link of that video in the description which you can watch later. But SpaceX is planning and designing Starship for multiple purposes, and one of the purpose is to use Starship to transport humans from one point to another on Earth. With current aviation technology, the shortest flight time between Los Angeles and London is 11 hours and 15 minutes. But Starship can cover this distance with just 40 minutes, which is way less than the traditional flight. This is just one scenario, but Starship can transport humans to any point on the Earth within an average time of 35 to 40 minutes. But how Starship will be able to cover such a vast distance in such a small time? The reason is lack of air. Normal commercial aircraft typically fly between 31,000 and 38,000 feet, which is about 5.9 to 7.2 miles or 9.5 to 11.5 km. But the presence of air molecules raises the aircraft, which slows down its speed significantly. The typical cruising airspeed for a long-distance commercial passenger aircraft is approximately 880 to 920 km per hour. But the Starship will fly through the vacuum of space, so it will not face any air resistance. After reaching into the space, the spacecraft will just glide through the emptiness of space, causing it to reach a speed of up to 27,000 km per hour, which is much larger than the commercial passenger aircraft. After reaching its destination, the Starship will again enter the Earth's atmosphere for a vertical landing, and will land mostly on an autonomous spaceport built into the ocean away from the shore, or on the dedicated landing site if the destination is not near to the ocean. The spaceports form a key part of this plan, because rockets generate a tremendous amount of sound waves, which can adversely affect the nearby people. So spaceports need to be built outside of a city and preferably in the ocean. 1/3 of total world population, which is nearly 2.4 billion people, lives nearly 100 km or 16 miles of an oceanic coast. Many of the world's populated cities like New York, Los Angeles, Shanghai, and Mumbai all reside near the ocean. So it is very practical to build spaceports in the ocean. Musk suggested in November 2019 that SpaceX would have to build a spaceport around 20 miles away from the shore. This would help ensure acceptable noise level, considering it will often daily flights. That's quite a distance compared to the regular airports. For example, New York's John F. Kennedy Airport is just over 12 miles from Grand Central Terminal. Musk suggested that the spaceport could be linked up with the Hyperloop, which is a vacuum-sealed pod transit system that Musk claims could reach up to 700 miles per hour. But these would not be fun flights. While flying to Mars could allow for enough cabin space for 2 to 3 people to comfortably share a room, the intra-Earth flight could hold up to 1,000 people with no space for amenities. Also, during the launch of a flight, passengers may experience a G-force rating up to 3G. 1G means normal gravitational force at sea level, which we all experience all the time. But during higher G value, our blood starts to flow towards our lower body, causing the brain to receive lower blood supply, and long exposure to the higher G value may cause unconsciousness. So these might not be an ideal flight for children, pregnant women, old age people, and people with any kind of heart disease. Currently, SpaceX is a master of reusing its rockets. SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket family have been launched 100 times over 10 years, resulting in 98 full mission successes with a success ratio of almost 98%. This is a mind-boggling success ratio, but SpaceX is trying to achieve 100% accuracy for the human flights. As for the price, SpaceRew estimated in October 2017 that it could work out to somewhere around $1,200 per person initially. But as the number of flights will increase, the cost will drop significantly. Currently, SpaceX is developing and building Starship spacecraft at Boca Chica, Texas. On October 28 this year, SpaceX has successfully tested the SN8 prototype with 3 Raptor engines. And on the 22nd of October, SpaceX installed a nose cone on SN8 prior to attempting a 15-kilometer hop. Elon Musk and SpaceX is targeting mid of 2021 or early 2022 to start commercial operation of Starship, but delays may cause it to start operations at the end of 2022. But if SpaceX has able to successfully achieve great accuracy and convenience at low cost, then it will completely revolutionize the concept of travel for humanity, and it will certainly give a big blow to the current airline industry. So within the next decade, we may travel frequently through the space. So do you think SpaceX will completely change the airline industry? And will you travel in the Starship spacecraft for your business or vacation travel? Give your thoughts in the comment section. Also share this video and subscribe to our channel. And I will see you in the next video.